Woo, man.
Tenet is Christopher Nolan's newest movie and follows a secret agent who uses time travel technology on a mission to stop World War III. So like most people, I'm a big fan of Nolan's movies because of how original they feel. No matter what you think of his more mind-bending films like Inception and Memento, you gotta respect him for trying to put ideas out there that feel totally fresh in an industry buried by derivative sequels and remakes. Tenet is definitely one of those unique ideas, but I feel like its complexity is both the movie's biggest strength and its biggest weakness. To show you what I mean, I'm gonna be comparing it a lot to Inception because I can't help but see the story similarities between those movies and how Inception excels where Tenet lacks. So anyway, the first half of Tenet drags considerably because of the sheer amount of expositional dialogue needed to give us background on the mission and how the time travel tech works. At the beginning of the film, the protagonist is constantly shifting between different locations just to sit down and talk to monotone characters whose sole purpose is just to deliver information to the audience. Think back to Inception when Leo's character Cobb is explaining how the dream technology works. It's way more entertaining because of the insane visuals and the emotional reactions of the characters. Meanwhile, in Tenet, when the scientist is explaining the time travel tech to the protagonist for the first time, there's not much energy or wonder injected into the scene. The protagonist acts mildly intrigued, asks some follow-up questions, and we're off to the next expositional scene. Wouldn't you want your audience to marvel at how cool your time travel idea is the first time you clearly show it off? Also, Inception's explanation scene doesn't just provide exposition, it gives us a vital character moment that continues to flesh out Cobb's inner demons, more specifically, his relationship with his dead wife. Tenet's lead, on the other hand, is a miserable excuse for a character. For starters, he doesn't even have a name. At one point in the movie, he literally calls himself the protagonist.
I'm the protagonist.
This guy is literally the definition of a vessel whose only purpose is to guide us through the plot of the film. And that's one of the bigger issues here. Tenet is almost all plot and no story. And for those of you who don't know the difference, plot is what happens, but story is how those events make the characters feel. Protagonist doesn't really have a reason to be the main character. He doesn't even really have any emotional stakes in the plot. On the flip side, in Inception, Cobb is an interesting lead because he has a personal purpose he's working toward. We root for Cobb to succeed in the mission because if he does, Saito will clear his criminal status, which will allow Cobb to reunite with his family. This is an emotional motivation that we can get behind, but in Tenet, protagonist is just trying to save the world from something we've only been told about. It's not really a tangible threat. Additionally, while Cobb has to get over the loss of his wife at the end of his mission to succeed, protagonist doesn't have to make a similar sacrifice. For the most part, he's basically the same character from beginning to end, just another faceless drone running around with everyone else. Now, you could argue that Elizabeth Debicki's character Kat fills that emotional void, but it begs the question, why is she then relegated to being a supporting character? In my opinion, I think it may have been better to have her be the lead since she has a bigger personal stake in the story, being the wife of the main villain. Kat could have been a more relatable character to guide us through this world, and for those of you who know about the Kat and Neil theory, that's just more of a reason to have the relationship be in the forefront of the story. I get what they were trying to do with protagonist and Neil, but I really didn't feel like there was a real friendship there. It could have helped to have some extra scenes that aren't totally in line with the plot so that we can grow some attachment to these guys. Kinda like the singing scene in Jaws. You know, like some chill time between some buddies. The ending scene does reveal some interesting information about protagonist, but it's not super mind-blowing because it comes in literally the last 10 minutes and is heavily reliant on a small detail that most people won't pick up on during their first viewing. And that's another thing. Yes, Tenet is one of those movies that you'll definitely like better the more times you watch it. However, I feel that the overcomplexity of the movie's concept and how it works to move the plot along makes it much more of a necessity to rewatch it to truly get the best experience. Movies like Inception and Get Out are similar in that respect, but I feel like the first viewings for both of those movies were good enough for me to fully grasp their concepts. Any rewatches afterwards just made me appreciate all of the smaller details. Tenet was fucked though. I had to go on Wikipedia to actually make sure I understood the main plot. I went on YouTube to look up all the chronological timelines of each character, and even then, I still feel like I didn't totally understand the whole inversion time switching concept. The night after the movie, I was literally just awake in my bed thinking about it.
Don't try to understand it.
There's even a scene right before the final battle where some military guy is literally lecturing us about what's about to happen. Nolan probably knew how convoluted the film may be for general audiences, but at that point, if you have such a complex concept you're trying to build a story around, it might be better to simplify the story so that there isn't so much you have to explain. In Inception, once all the dream mechanics are explained in the first act, the mission is set in motion and there isn't much time spent on stopping to explain things. This kept the film moving without having to sacrifice pacing for more exposition. Now, I understand that it sounds like I fucking hate this movie, but I still found myself enjoying my time watching it for the most part. A little more than halfway through the movie, when the time gimmick is more oftenly used, the visuals on display here are fucking mesmerizing. There are also a lot of small details that really go to show how much thought was put into the logic of how an inverted person would move backwards in time. Watching a guy moving forwards in time fight another guy moving backwards in time gave me the same exciting feeling I had when I first saw the Inception ceiling fight. I honestly think this movie may have had some of Nolan's best action scenes. If only the action was this good in the Dark Knight franchise. Rip. And like I said at the beginning of the video, you gotta at least give Nolan props for doing something new here. It's the same way I feel about movies like Jordan Peele's Us and M. Night Shyamalan's Glass. They may not be perfect, but they at least did something interesting in their respective genres. I'm gonna give Tenet a 7 out of 10, giving it an extra half point for that dope soundtrack. If you saw the movie, comment below what you thought about it, because I know this is going to be a divisive one. And lastly, make sure to subscribe and hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.